Can mathematics predict the future? People have long imagined what the future holds, whether that's long-term or short-term. Some modern applications of big data crunching include Facebook predicting when a couple will enter a relationship, history looking for patterns when violence will spike, or researchers choosing the best March Madness bracket. But what if past behavior is irrelevant for predictions? The trajectory of a woman jumping off a cliff doesn't depend on what she did an hour earlier, but rather on her initial position and speed and the forces of gravity, wind, and air resistance. Mathematician Pierre-Simon Laplace asserted that if we have full knowledge of everything at one instant of time and understand how things change as time progresses, we could, at least theoretically, predict the future. In other words, if you know what a system is like now and know the rules for how it will change, then you know what it will be like in the future. Let's illustrate this with a simple mathematical model, the game of life. Start with a grid where at a given moment each cell is either alive, shaded black, or dead, shaded white. In the next generation, each cell stays the same or changes according to the following four rules. 1. Any live cell with fewer than two live neighbors dies, as if caused by underpopulation. 2. Any live cell with two or three live neighbors lives on to the next generation. 3. Any live cell with more than three live neighbors dies, as if by overcrowding. And 4. Any dead cell with exactly three live neighbors becomes a live cell as if by reproduction. These rules produce interesting dynamics such as still lifes that don't change, oscillators, and spaceships that move across the grid. Starting with just a few cells on, you can see that the dynamics can be pretty crazy. The point is that knowing the state of every cell in one generation and knowing the rules lets us determine each cell's state at any time in the future. Another example is called Langton's ant. Again, let each cell be either black or white. An ant starts at one cell pointing in a specified direction. At each step, there are two possible moves. 1. If the ant starts at a white square, turn 90 degrees right, flip the color of the square, and move forward 1 unit. Or 2, if the ant starts at a black square, turn 90 degrees left, flip the color of the square, and move forward 1 unit. Starting on a completely white grid, something fascinating happens. The ant's progress seems somewhat random, but after about 10,000 moves, the ant starts moving along a highway forever. In fact, it seems that no matter how the grid is initially colored, a highway eventually appears. Nobody can prove this or explain why it happens. The game of life and Langton's ant bring out a challenge to predicting the future. We can do a lot of calculations to see what happens after, say, 1 million steps, but usually there is no theorem that immediately tells you what that state will be. In contrast to these scenarios that use time moving in a stepwise manner, models for studying fluid flow, planetary motion, or the weather use continuous time. Sometimes the equations involved, like for studying how a planet moves around the sun, can be solved exactly, so we can predict where any planet will be located with great accuracy. But fluid flow is governed by the Navier-Stokes equations, differential equations which are impossible to solve exactly, but are critical to modeling weather, airflow which produces flight, and of course, water flow. Understanding solutions to these equations is so important that the Clay Mathematics Institute is offering a $1 million prize for concrete progress. Researchers can solve these equations approximately, but the errors from the approximations grow over time. You can see this when a double pendulum is released at nearly identical initial states. The positions change radically over time. This is why weather prediction is so difficult. Approximate solutions to equations and the growth of errors means it's nearly impossible to accurately predict the weather after several days. You can check this yourself by looking at the predicted highs and lows in your area for 1 week later and compare it to what actually happens. Other factors, like geography, can magnify this instability. Of course, if we have some control in our system, like firing thrust out from a lander, we may be able to adjust for any instability and predict the kind of future we want. Or not.